Welcome to Touchline. I'm your host, Anthony Totter, here in the OSA studios with Bobby Arushi. He is the president of the Toronto Azure Youth Soccer Club. Bobby, thanks for joining us here on Touchline.
Anthony.
Bobby, I wanted to have you here today to talk about your youth club. You're part of the North York Soccer Association. You're a busy guy, Bobby. You're all over. Why would you start out a youth club and get involved and give all your time and effort to this? Please let the viewers know.
Well, because soccer is part of my life, and I wouldn't be who I am today without the game of soccer, and I think it's only natural for people like myself to want to give back. And with me is the old group of Azzurris that I grew up with when we played in downtown Toronto at the Robina YMCA, and that was in the 60s, and we created a wonderful club run by selfless individuals who became our coaches and our managers, and I think we want to do a little bit of what they did for us.
Bobby, talk about some of the guys that are on board with you. Some of these guys do a lot of work, a lot of thankless work at this club. Talk about some of them.
Well, there's so many that make up the Azzurri, but basically it's a lot of the guys that I played with back in those days, Orazio De Chantis, Joe Mancuso, or are on the board, Ralph Chicha, who's a prominent lawyer in Woodbridge, Mario Borsato. I mean, affiliated is also Carmen Marcantonio, Lucky Razzo, Paul D'Agostino, some of the players that became great national players for Canada. And so we would like to do a little of the same. We also have a very unique situation where we are, Anthony, because we were bestowed 5 acres on the Keel Street Reservoir site, which is on the southeast corner of Keel and Steeles. For those of you who, when you go to York University, you're going north on Keel, I'm sure you'll look up to your right and you'll see the reservoir. There's about 25 beautiful, lush acres of grass up there. We have 5 acres where there's a stadium field, and we're going to be building a clubhouse there. So we really believe in creating a soccer center of excellence, but not only for soccer, for the community. In this clubhouse, we eventually will do programs for culture, for vocational education. We're affiliated with Sergeant Steve Hicks in the 31 Division. We want to get a lot of the kids in the Jane Finch corridor off the streets and onto the soccer pitch.
What I love hearing about this, Bobby, is you want to build a young man and a young woman, not
yes.
just a soccer player. And this is unique. I haven't heard about this. We talked about the soccer aspect, but this is great stuff.
Talk
a little bit about
it. It's unique,
that.
Anthony. I can't say that it was in the plans from the beginning, but we came upon it because when we got into the community, and the Keel Street Reservoir land became available, then when we met Sergeant Steve Hicks and we found out all the good things he was doing, we started to meet good people like the Lions Club of our community, and Canadian Tire has a great program that sponsors a young man or a young boy or a young girl for house league programs. We saw it as an opportunity to not only teach them the game of soccer, but also some life lessons and skills.
Bobby, what I love about your club is that you don't cut corners. Your club is very unique, where you have some of the best fields your house league kids play on. I'm surprised. I'm very happy that is happening. You got to be honest, Bobby. In the North York Soccer Association, we talk with Spartacus and Weston. There are some of the worst fields possible in all of the province of Ontario that these clubs are playing on. But you made it something very important that the field had to be good for your kids to play on.
It's a very good point. We were not going to start this project at all unless we played on well-manicured fields. So what we did was we went to York University, and their athletic fields are pretty well manicured. They do a good job. They're not the best fields, but they are good fields. And we knew that we could develop young boys and girls and have them enjoy the game of soccer on an excellent pitch. That's what we're doing at the Toronto Azzurri Sport Village, which is what it will be called. The stadium club, the stadium field is well manicured. We spend $10,000 to $12,000 a year for servicing the field, and we're going to do the same with the rest of the fields that are around the area. You know, I mean, if you're going to get into the game, you have to do the right things for the boys and girls to play on it. If you build it, they will come, but you have to build it well.
And you're starting out well, and you've done well so far because you're letting the kids play on some premium grass up at the York University Center. Bobby, I want to talk a little bit about something, not just in your soccer association, North York, but in other soccer associations across its provinces. I remember way back when with my kids attending some of these league meetings, associations, waiting for a roll call and my name to be called. I was waiting forever. I think, in my opinion, and then you can echo on this if you want, is if a new club has to start, it has to start with a certain number of kids registered, enrolled in their club, and then they can have a club registered in that association. Because I think we're just giving out licenses and permits for clubs to start out, and that is a problem, I think.
Well, I mean, I've spoken with Ron Smale, I've spoken with Guy Bradbury about this. I really do believe that sooner or later we're going to have to identify, you know, champions of the community, of a community. And I think a club, in order for it to be effective, it needs to also be powerful member of that community, and also needs to be affiliated politically in the community, with sponsors in that community. If you have too many clubs all going for the same sponsorship card, or all trying to get a meeting with the mayor, or all trying to get fields from Parks and Rec, then really what you're doing is you're watering the product.
Yes.
So the hockey teaches us, the OHA, Ontario Hockey Association, has, you know, Guelph, Kitchener, Markham, Newmarket, and I think there's a lot to follow from that. I'm not saying that we have to disrespect all of the great clubs that have contributed to soccer to date, but I think sooner or later you also have to recognize that you can't develop young boys and girls unless you have the cherry on the parfait, which is the senior expression. We don't have a league that offers the senior expression of this game. You cannot develop boys and girls unless they play in the maximum expression of the game available, and you need to raise that standard.
And you have that standard at your youth club, Bobby, where you've surrounded yourself with a lot of ex-players or guys that have played the game at a high level and have come back to give, to teach the proper way, unlike some other clubs that are, unfortunately, they're stuck with letting mom and dad, who a lot of them do a great job, but some of them just don't understand even the basics. Well, your club has stepped up to the plate and done more.
Well, we've tried to. I mean, we our house league as well has a lot of great parents that coach. But we try to assimilate as many of the ex-Zuri members as possible, and so that there's always supervision. We play in the same site so that on Mondays and Wednesdays, parents can talk to an Zuri member at any time. The thing that we haven't done is really develop the rep programs, and I really don't think it's you can develop rep programs unless you have a proper home. So we want to put our home in order. Once we have our stadium field, we have our clubhouse built, which we intend on doing this year, and hopefully we'll be able to get more fields in the immediate reservoir area. Then what you do is you have your center of excellence, and then that's when those boys and girls who play for your club feel like they're a member of a club.
And this is the way it should be done, Bobby. A lot of clubs want to get rep teams in there for, let's be honest, the revenue, where you want to start it out and do it more properly, more right.
Well, you need revenue too, Anthony. There's no question about it, because you need a critical mass of membership. And that should also be a criteria for being a club. I think you need, I always use Oakville as a great example. Mm-hmm. Oakville is one club in one community, and look what they've built there.
Biggest club in Canada.
They have that fantastic center of indoor and outdoors soccer. They are the club in that community. If you live in Oakville, you go to the Oakville Soccer Club. And I think that that's a role model for the province to really model for other communities. And once you get your 30 or 35 great communities with kind of that one club of excellence, then each one of these clubs puts a senior team and you have your league, A division, B division.
Yeah, those are great points. What are some of the future endeavors that your club has in store for the upcoming months, maybe just this year or years ahead, Bob?
Well, it's an exciting year. 2011, we are going to put the shovel in the ground for our clubhouse. It's a 5,000 square foot multi-purpose facility. As I said, we're going to have the police are going to be there offering guidance for the community. We're going to have local 506, which is a laborers union, and they're going to teach some of the kids some of the trades, which we believe is a great alternative. Not everybody can go to university and not everybody can go to secondary school, but we do have these good people that are going to be part of this center, which of course is also going to be soccer centric. But we're going to have this 2,000 square foot open area which we can use for gymnastics, for music programs, as I said, for cultural programs. So we really want it to be just more than just sport. It is part. We want it to be a fabric of the community.
Well, you let us know here on Touchline. When that shovel goes in, we'll come out there. Wonderful. And we'll film it, and we'll make sure that it goes out there to the public.
It's something unique and something we can be proud of. And you know, it doesn't need Bobby Rucci to run it. It can be, you know, any responsible individual that believes in the same principles that the Toronto Missouri believe in.
That's something I've always known about you, Bobby. You don't like to put yourself in the front, but I will do that for you. You've done a lot for the kids out there in the community. You continue to do it with your people there at Toronto Missouri, and I'm sure you will echo this. You'll love seeing the kids smile. Banquet day, pitcher day, just a regular tournament day. Talk about what that means to you.
It's very fulfilling. We call it the Adjury Day, of course, okay. Because but we do exactly what you've intimated at Anthony. We have a celebratory day at the end of our development league, and all the parents come out with their grandmas, and we have hot dogs and pops for everybody, and we get it all sponsored, so nobody has to go into their pocket. And they play their playoff games, and each level, gets rewarded with trophies. And you're right, it's very rewarding, and there are a lot of smiles on a lot of faces. So it's sometimes you feel like it's a lot of work, and you wonder if it's worth it. But when you see those kids and their parents, their faces light up. Then of course it is worth it.
Just before we let you go, Bobby, we're here at the OSA Center. I'm sure that you've seen that there's a vibe in the air. There's change that's happening. Ron Smale has brought a lot of that freshness, that change that's happening. What would you like to see different? And what would you like to also mention out there that's been something good that's happened at the OSA in the past year or so?
Well, I think Ron Smale is a great person to start with. Ron Smale has championed change at the national level. I'm sure everybody's aware of the changes in the governance of the game. We need change. We need new dynamic people in the game. I think Ron Smale, as president of Ontario, needs to focus on Ontario.
Yes.
And leave the national focus to a different group of people that are business oriented, that are champions of communities and champions of business and commerce and trade, and of course you need soccer people as well as the new board of the CSA. But because of Ron Smale and Guy Bradbury's leadership, Ontario, being the biggest province, was able to propel this change, and in 3 years we will not have any more provincial presidents on the CSA board, which is a tremendous achievement, and that's not to knock the men and women that have been there in the past, but we need a change. This game needs to grow. It can't grow under the current constitution. It needs new dynamics, it needs new power, it needs a lot more money, it needs fundraising capabilities, it needs to create more revenue streams, and our national programs need this money essentially to compete at a world level. And we cannot compete at a world level unless we equip ourselves properly.
Well said. There's nothing to add to that, but before we let you go, give out the website if mom and dad want to register their young boy and girl with your club and where you're situated as well, Bobby.
Yes. Well, you can contact the Toronto Missouri at www.torontoadzuri.com. That's two Z's and two R's, Adzuri, A-Z-Z-U-R-R-I. And our number is 416-782-1578. We have an office at the Columbus Center at the corner of Lawrence and Dufferin, and we play out of the Keele Street Reservoir and York University.
And York University, yeah. That's great. Bobby, thanks for joining
us
on Touchline. Keep up the great work. You never stop giving back to the community, kids. I really appreciate that. I've known you for a number of years. Keep it up.
Thank you, Anthony.
Thank you very much.
Thanks kindly. Touchline. Thank you.